Hello and welcome on back to TutsByKai. I'm Kai and today we are making this cool animated text effect in Blender. So let's get started really quickly. We're going to delete the default cube, camera, and lamp. Everything got to go. So I'm going to hit one on my numpad to go to the front facing view. And we're going to go over here to create and we're going to add in a text object. To rotate that on the 90 degree on the X axis, we're going to hit R, X, and 90 on our numpad. Left click to confirm the selection. All right, so we're going to edit this text by hitting tab on our keyboard, and we're going to delete all that out, and we're going to just type in, animated. So instead of typing in the full word animated, I'm just going to type in an A, a capital A, and we're going to hit tab to get out of that. All right, so now pretty much what we have to do is we have to make sure that all of these letters are separate. So I'm going to drag over this panel, and I'm going to go to the font tab over here. All the way over on the right, and we're going to go alignment center, and we're going to go alignment center. But as you can tell, that's not very centered, so we're going to go over here to this Y, and we're just going to play around with that and put it somewhere right, about right there. It looks pretty good. All right, so we're going to change this font because that's not very good to look at. I'm just going to use the font called Anton that I have in here, and I'm going to fix it up because the offset is once again off because we changed the font. Maybe something like 2.5. Yeah, looks pretty good. All right, so now what we're going to do is we have to duplicate this letter, all the letters for animated. So every single letter that's in animated, we need to duplicate this A and then make it say the right letter. So instead of that saying A, we're going to duplicate that with Shift D, and then we're going to drag that on over, and we're going to go N, make sure that's capital, and then we're going to go I, do the same thing, Shift D, and move it over, and I, and then the same thing with the M. Drag it over a little bit more. Same thing with the A. Actually, we could just take this A and duplicate this A and move that over. And then the same thing all the way through. Hey. All right, so now we have all of the letters for the word animated. And now we're going to go back to our camera view. Excuse me, our front-facing view. Just like that. And hit 5 on my numpad to go into orthographic, by the way. And we're going to move these about to where they need to be spacing-wise. We're going to clean this up. Make sure it looks all nice and neat before we start animating the letters. Move them all over, something like that. And you want to keep in mind when you're doing this, like I said, they all can't be on the same text object. They all have to be different so we can animate them separately. So we're going to add in our camera, and we're going to scroll that back to about right there. Hit 0 on a numpad to go into camera view. And we're going to select all these, hit B on your keyboard, and just drag that box open so we can move it all the way over. Try and get that somewhere center and scale it up. Hit S on your keyboard and just move your mouse to scale that up. Somewhere about right there. So this looks pretty good, but it's not doing anything right now. So we're going to go down to our timeline, drag that open a little bit, and make our start frame 0 instead of 1. So now we're going to take all these, with all these selected, we're going to move them down a little bit. Actually, wait, you know, we're going to go to the 5th frame. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we're going to hit I, insert location. All right, so now what this has done is pretty much it's just inserted this location where they're at right now on the 5th frame. We're going to go back to the first frame, the 0 frame actually. And we're going to move those down just a little bit, just like right there. And then hit I, location. So now what they do is this. That's what they do. They just move a little bit just like that. That's it. So what we want to do is we want to make sure all of these are separate. So the way to do this, instead of, you know, going to the 5th frame and then making this one lag behind the A and this one behind the N, this one behind the I, we're going to go to our dope sheet editor. So we're going to change, we're going to hit this box and change this to dope sheet. And now every other keyframe, we're going to want to change this. Now this would be a little tricky because it's not just a single keyframe, as you can tell. They look like there's three there, you know, and there's one up there. It's just weird. So we're going to downsize all these. We're going to collapse all of these. These are pretty much just our text objects. Just letting us know all of the different, you know, locations. We can change all the different keyframes for all those. But we don't want that. We just need to change them in general. So now it's much easier to work with. As you can tell, there's just one keyframe for each letter. So what we're going to do is this is the first text object up here. The first two keyframes is the first text object. The second one is the second two. So we're going to take all of these except for the first one, and we're going to move that over. We're going to move it over by one frame. Now we're going to take all of the rest of them and do the same thing. So we're going to keep doing that. Kind of looks like a waterfall stepping effect. something like that, like stairs or something. We're going to keep doing that over and over again and getting rid of the first one every single time, the uppermost one. All right. And we're going to keep going, hitting B and hitting G to move our keyframes, by the way. G on our keyboard to move them. Just like that. And I'm scrolling in and out with my mouse and clicking pans around. So now we have this completely finished. Now everything is like a waterfall stepping effect. And if we go back to our scene, you can tell that this has a cool animated animation, right? Looks like that. Looks pretty cool. Now everything is separate and it works perfectly great. There's a lot of other things you can do with this. You can make this fade in and out, which is what we're going to do. So we're going to go to our materials tab. And now what I should have done earlier was, before I duplicated all these, I should have gave this all the same text object. But the reason we didn't do that is because we need to animate all of them separately. So it's just much easier to do it this way. So we're going to hit this little box here. We're going to click the first material. And we're just going to drag the intensity to 100, the specularity down to 0, and make sure this is all the way on white. So we're going to go ahead and do that for the rest of these letters as well. We're going to hit new, drag that all the way up, all the way down. Now that we've done all of these layers, now that we've done all the text objects, we can now animate them. So pretty much what we're just going to be doing is we're going to go down here to transparency and make sure this is on for all of these as well. Go down to transparency, make sure all of these boxes are checked. Oops, not like that. Make sure all these boxes are checked, and we're going to go all the way across. So we're going to start on A, and these three keyframes down here, assuming the five keyframes, we're going to make sure that at the first one, this is completely transparent. You can't see it at all. We're going to drag that all the way down. If we give this a quick render, you'll be able to see the A is not there anymore. So we're going to make sure that's all the way down. Hit I, hover your cursor inside of this alpha box, and then hit I on your keyboard. And we're going to move to the fifth frame, and we're going to turn that all the way up and hit I on your keyboard. So now if we render this, you can tell that the A is there again. So pretty much what this did, but it transitioned between being not able to be seen and being able to be seen. So it has this really cool, nice fading in animation. So if I go to material, if I go to material, you should be able to see that it gets lighter like that, right? So now it's not there. It slowly comes into focus, just like that. Looks pretty cool, fading into the camera like that. So we're going to do that for the rest of the frames as well. So we're going to go from here. We're going to go to the fifth frame, hit I. That's going to go to the sixth frame for the N. And then the first frame, and we're going to drag that all the way down, hit I. With the I, we're going to do the same thing. Make sure that is all the way up, hit I. So I've done all of the animating for the transparency. Now let's go back to material mode and see if we can see the difference. Look how cool that looks. Look at that. Awesome. Now when they come up, they fade in, so you can't see that they were just sitting there. So that's a really, really cool effect. The last thing we're going to need to do is we're going to set up our background. We're going to go to Ambient Occlusion. We're going to hit the World tab and hit Ambient Occlusion so we can make everything white in our scene, nice and bright so there's no shading. And then we're going to go down to, we're going to hit horizontal color, and we're going to drag that all the way down to black. Excuse me, horizon color, horizontal color, I said horizontal. And we're going to drag it all the way down to black, just like that. Boom. All right, I've saved my project, which we should have done earlier, but now we have this entire animated text. And as you can tell, it's white because we have on the ambient occlusion. We didn't have a light in our scene, and I didn't want to add one. So we hit ambient occlusion. So we're pretty much done. That is it. That's how you do that. A few of the rendering options, you can, of course, add in sampled motion blur if you're in Blender Render. If you're in Cycles, then, of course, you can just hit motion blur. But since we did all of the animating of the transparency inside of Blender Render, you'd have to go through a different step to do that in Cycles. So let's go back to Blender Render, make sure everything is still A-OK, and it is. Just like that. So that is pretty much it. Make sure, you know, you have all your settings. We're going to go for H.264, RGB. And MP4, and then of course the output to wherever you want it to render to. Make sure that's all the way up as well. So that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial. I'll be posting more just like this in the future. So if you enjoyed it, make sure you subscribe for more tutorials just like this. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. Hey, 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 hey. TutsByKai.